What should Bob do? Well, I guess this is more of a fun question, but I would suggest the better option here is B, leave her a message, please call me back. Rather than just keep calling her, keep calling N all the time, just the simple leaving a message and instructing her to call back is probably easier. So this is what actually also happens in Swing, and I will introduce this in a minute. Just going through the structure again, Bob would now actually leave that message, please call me back. When the event occurs, N can ring Bob and say, hi Bob, what's up? And looking at the same structure now in Swing, we will see that that's exactly what's happening in Swing. We have a control. This could be, for example, a button. And we have an action listener. Action listener is a new class that you would create. Or it could extend an existing class. And this action listener is listening, just as the word says, to any actions occurring. And this action listener now would say to the control, in this case to the button, please call me back. I want to know about the events that occur. I want to know when you receive a click. And then when the click actually occurs, the control, the button, would call this method in the action listener, in this my action listener class. In this case, it's called action performed method. There are different methods, but for the moment, stick with this. This is what we will use most frequently, the action performed method. This is called event driven programming. Swing is actually relying on this idea that things are driven by events. Whenever something happens in the graphical user interface, for example, when a button is clicked, but also when a menu changes, when the size of a frame changes, when you click, when you press a key, all this triggers events. Now, these events can now be handled by different parts of the program. They could be, or there will be, these event or action listeners, and they can respond to those events. This is called event-driven programming, or an event-driven program. There are actually two ways of how to do this. We could, as Bob did, we could have a class that keeps monitoring another class, that keeps monitoring, say, this button, and check on a regular basis whether the button was clicked. Second option would be that we introduce this callback idea, that we leave a notification, this action listener actually says, look, I want to know about all the events that occur. When a click occurs, please call me back. And that's exactly what's happening in Swing. Swing uses this callback approach. So just checking whether you're actually listening. Which type of event handling is used in Swing? Is it so-called read evaluation loop? Or is it notification based? Or is it ticket-based?